Hello, everyone. It's me again. I hope that you will get accustomed to my face in the next few days. The first back to the live stream of Data Science Conference Europe, stream the business application of data and AI. We had a chance previously to listen to George Kokai from IKEA, who delivered us an excellent talk about how we moved IKEA into digital age. And the only one thing to say that we are continuing in the same manner. So our next speaker, distinguished speaker, will be Pavel Škripek, who will tell us more about a review of the latest time series, forecasting methods with real examples. In his presentation, he will present the latest state of the art of machine learning methods for time series forecasting. And basically, some of you for sure know that the most innovative AI methods are ANBITS, ES hybrid transformer-based methods, CLI machine, and GluonTS. And they will be presented with some practical examples inside of this talk. Also, the results of best forecasting method for financial time series will be presented and evaluated. He will also discuss about future direction of development and what are the most promising areas of application that he will show. Only one thing to add that Pavel is an experienced architect of IT solutions, in particular in the field of processing large data sets and machine learning solution, and that he is a technical director of Melodic multi-cloud optimization and management platform. As well, Pavel is the second time in a row speaker at Data Science Conference. He was last here live in Belgrade, and I would like to welcome him to the stage in front of the whole organization. So take it, Pavel.
Hello, good afternoon. I hope you can hear me well. Yes, that's true that I'm a second time, so thank you very much for the invitation. I hope I could extend my presentation from the previous year and to tell about the more advanced method, what has been changed from that time and what we could recommend in terms of the time series forecasting. I'm responsible for the technical side of the development in the AI investments. We are focusing on the building the advanced investments method using AI and machine learning approaches. So I will tell very briefly about that. Okay. Agenda for today's presentation, very briefly, I will tell about us, so why we are using, what kind of the machine learning and AI we are using for the investing, what are our principles and how we approach that. And then I will focus on the time series forecasting, as promised in the presentation. I will start with some background information, then I will tell about the M4 and M5 competition, which is very important event for that. And then I will analyze this briefly present and analyze this five presented time series forecasting method. And at the end, I will show our results because we are using this method, these methods in practice, in a real platform, and how it works together. Yeah, so first, why AI-based investing? You are here because you believe that the AI data science is the future, and I fully agree with that. And also the staff and the team in our company also agree with that. And that's the reason that we are thinking that using the AI methods for the investments is the right option. Of course, it's not an easy option. I will tell why and what are the problems and issues. But on the other hand, it could give the real edge, real benefits, and also I will tell about that why. Our company is working on that solution for almost 3 years, and we have already real track record, so I could we have a proof that this method works and could improve investments results, but also it can be used in any other areas of the business and application. Time series forecasting is not only applicable to the investment, but also to the many others areas. How it works in our case? Our investment process is divided in the three parts. One part is responsible for the analysis, and here we are using the financial time series forecasting. Second part is responsible for the portfolio optimization, because we know that this time series forecasting is not 100% sure. It is not even 8% sure, but the current accuracy is around 60-65%. It is quite good or even very good, but it's still not a 100%. So that's the reason that we have this portfolio optimization, our trading strategies, and also in that part we are using machine learning based methods, but it's probably will be topic of the another presentation. And the third part is execution, so we are directly execute transaction on the market, and currently this part is not AI supported. So we have the analysis, so we try to predict the future price on the given of various markets, various financial instruments. Based on that predictions, using our trading strategies and portfolio optimization, we construct the portfolio in which we want to invest, and then we are executing the final transaction on the market. We consider that our approach as a so-called alpha factor. Alpha in the investments world is this edge, something which could generate us the better return than just simple buy and hold or risk-free investment. And in our case, this alpha factor works that we are continuously looking for the new time series forecasting method, new pattern recognition method, new optimization method, new trading strategies and other optimization, and continuously improve our platform. So on the today's presentation, it will be some kind of the update comparing to the last year presentation. I will tell about different time series forecasting method, which we have analyzed and applied through the last year, since the last data science conference. What is time series forecasting? That's usually a very boring topic, because the time series forecasting means that we want to predict the next or set of the next values in the given series. For example, for the financial market, we want to predict the price of the given stock, given bond, or other instrument in the future. For the sales forecasting, we want to predict the value, how much of the product we can sell in the given time horizon. For the health issues, we could predict that something will change in the health data related to the given patient. And there are any very, very big area of potential application of the time series forecasting. The special, usually till that time, the statistical methods were used as for the time series forecasting. I will show on the next slide the most popular one, but since about the three or some 3 years, the machine learning time series forecasting method becomes dominant, and it gives the significantly better results than statistical one, especially for the time series which are difficult to predict, which are heteroscedastic, skewed, non-stationary, and financial time series are that category of time series. So that's the reason that machine learning methods are probably the best choice for that. For the statistical method, I think here we have the most important one. First family is the regression, different type of the regression, then ARMA and ERMA models, ARCH and CHARCH, exponential smoothing, theta method, and very big family of the methods based on the ensembling of the different different methods. The ensembling was especially important for the statistical methods because each of the method itself was quite poor predictor, but using the ensemble approach could improve significantly the results. Of course, the ensemble can be used and is used also for the machine learning method. And till the 2018, the time series forecasting was mostly done using the statistical methods, but the so-called M4 competition, is the most prestigious time series forecasting competition organized by Professor Makridiakis from the University of Nicosia. Professor Makridiakis is a legend and probably the best authority for the time series prediction, and in this M4 competition the goal was to predict 100,000 different time series. The best method was the one which predict on average in the best way the 100,000 different time series with different frequency from the different domain. So this method is really robust because it is not just overfit to the given domain or given frequency or given time series, but it's really really good on the very wide area of the possible time series. That was some kind of the breakthrough, and since that time the machine learning methods dominate the time series forecasting. The next edition of the competition, M5, was dominated by the machine learning models. It has a different construction, so it's not a one-to-one comparison, but it was definitely dominated by the machine learning methods. First method which I want to describe is the method which won the M4 competition. It is the exponential smoothing hybrid method developed by Sławek Smyl and presented in this paper. So I suggest to, if you are interested in the time series forecasting, that should be probably the most important method to look at. The paper is very good, very detailed, so you could learn a lot about that method. I want to highlight some very innovative elements which was used in that method. So first thing was data preprocessing, and the data preprocessing was included in the whole back propagation process. So for the parameters of the exponential smoothing, which was the method of the data processing, was built into the backpropagation process. So the neural network's weights and parameters of the exponential smoothing was learned during the one backpropagation. The second innovation was using the LSTM neural network, but not a typical one, but residual, deleted, and the first version of the LSTM with attention. The next innovation, which was at least in my opinion probably the most important one, was heavy using of models and sampling. There is a specific way how the models are ensembled and assigned to the given time series, and each of the time series is forecasted by the dedicated set of the models which are assigned to the given for the given time series, but the models are learned on the each of the time series. Yeah, so we are each model is learned on the select on the all of the time series, then it is assigned to the given time series, and different time series could share some models, but could also have the unique set of the models, and that's the at least in my opinion, the most important elements of that method, which gives its superiority in prediction this 100,000 different time series. I want to highlight this innovation in the LSTM architecture. You know, so we could say that the first innovation is deletion. So the LSTMs was used with the deletion. So the to the as the input parameters, not the sequence of the time series points was fed, but they was deleted. So depends on the deletion, it could be each point in the time series, it could be one and the third and fifth point, and so on. So deletion was the first innovation. The second innovation was residual connection in the LSTM. The residual connection and deletion was very heavy use for the image recognition. So this application for the time series forecasting was one of the first application of that method. It was based on the previous work dedicated to that architecture, but the ES hybrid method combine all of this innovation in one. So I would like to highlight that and how this method works and how we are using that. This method predicts the given number of the future points. So for example, we can predict the 10 or 20 future points. In our case, it is the price of the given financial instrument in the future. It could be daily or lower horizon, but assuming daily, we could, for example, predict the 10 future points of the given stock or bonds. And then our investment strategy could decide based on these 10 forecasted values, how it should behave for that stock. If we can see that this stock will go down and then up, then our strategy can wait and then buy or do whenever is forecasted to maximize the return on the investments, especially that we know that this forecasting is not the 100% sure. In fact, in our case, it is the 60 to 65% accuracy. Yeah? So we can invest all of the capital in the given prediction, but we need to properly optimize and manage that. And the second method, which I wanted to show, is the Facebook profit. It is probably the simplest and most easy method to start with, as the library is accessible. Here is the link to the library. Even it is very easy to start using. It's very powerful, and it is especially good for the optimization and sampling. Because it can very quickly adjust to the new data. So we are using the Facebook Prophet, but with these two additional things. One is the continuous optimization. So we are continuously optimize the parameters of the given model, and the parameters are the input or training period, and the number of the variables and the type of the data preprocessing. And we are also ensembling different Facebook Prophet models with the different parameters, and our final prediction is based on that. Facebook's Prophets also is able to generate the levels of the uncertainty, also called confidential levels. So we can see that if we go more in the future, then this uncertainty level is increasing, which is of course obvious, but we can measure that. And we could also base our decision on that fact, how big is this uncertainty level and the confidential level. The second ready to use and the third method today is the Gluon TS, which is also the complete framework which can be used, download and used. It is much more complicated than Facebook Prophet and is also based on the latest advanced neural networks architecture. So it's not as easy to start with, but it is much more powerful. It includes various methods and algorithms, including, for example, transformer networks, which can be used for the time series forecasting. And we are using that transformers method with very good results. And the very important thing that in the Gluon TS, we have a different method for the data transformation and the different models architecture, which could be combined and experiment to check which one could provide the best results. Also, Gluon has a very good cloud computing support, both for training as well as for the inference and prediction. And there is a very strong community support, so all questions would be probably quickly answered in case of the issue or problems. I'm not sure if it's the latest state of the Gluon. It could be checked on the Gluon website, but here we can see how the different components are combined in a different way, and how we can choose which one we can use. We can use different probabilistic distribution, probabilistic components. We have the state space models and Gaussian processes, network structure and neural network components. And currently the number of the neural network components is much more wider than presented here. So the framework is intensively developed, and it is also good choice to start with if you are seriously thinking about that time series forecasting. Okay, this three method we can consider as a, let's say, fundamental method, as hybrid is fundamental because it was the method which won the M4 competition. Next two frameworks are ready to use and very popular frameworks, so it is worth to start with them. Then I also want to say about two methods which are not so ready to use. use because they are based on the papers, but we also experience very good results with that. The first method is NBITS method. Here we have the reference to the paper. It is fully machine learning method with the very unique architecture based on the different type of the neural network blocks. There are blocks responsible for trends, seasonality, and generic blocks. And also there are some innovative approaches for the time series forecasting. I will show that on the next slide. And very important thing is that this method, comparing to the previous one, is putting also focus on the explainability. Yeah? So we can explain why this prediction is done that way, not just to give the prediction, which could be very important for the sum of the application. Of course, this prediction, this explainability is not the 100% sure, but at least it is the step in the right direction. Also, NBITS uses very advanced model ensembling, so the ensembling approach from the ES hybrid has been significantly enhanced in that version. Yeah, here is a brief architecture from the paper of that method. As we can go from the, say, this time right to left, we have the number of the stacks which are stacked. Each stack is forecasting the future value, and final forecasting is the combination of the forecasting from the each stack. Each stack is construct from the block with also the residual connection between the blocks, and each block provides its own prediction, which are combined as a stack stack forecasting, and the block is created in the presented here architecture. The very important thing is that from the block we have two output. One is called the backcast output, and the second is called forecast output. The forecast output is this one, which goes to the stack forecasting, and the backcast goes to the next block, as in the, say, typical architecture. And the NBIT methods works on the similar input and output data as ES hybrid. So we are providing the given number of the history of the time series and predict the horizon of the points in the future. So we can predict 10, 12, 20 points to the future using that method. So it is very similar. Authors of the paper claims that they have better results than than ES hybrid method. And the last method, which is probably the not as known as the previous method, is the using the time for Zetlin machines for the time series forecasting. Zetlin machine is also called stochastic learning automata. It is the algorithm which was developed in the 60s of the previous century by the Russian scientist called Zetlin, and this stochastic learning automata has not been widely used for the 50 or more years, but recently it is used both for the reinforcement learning as well as for the time series prediction. And it is not based on the neural network, but it is based on this algorithm, which is described in the book Stochastic Learning Automata. And how to use that Zetlin machines for prediction is described in this paper. You can see see the reference here. And very briefly, how this Zetlin machine works. This Zetlin machine is learning the probability distribution for the each parameters, and the final forecasting is done on the random choice for the this distribution. But in the training period, we put the data, choose the random results for each distribution, and then check what is the results and compare that to the real results. Then we adjust the distribution for the each parameter and so on. And after that training, that Zetlin machine could be used for the forecasting and comparing to the neural networks, which gives always the same prediction for the each input data. Of course, if we assume that it's stable models without changing the weights, Zetlin machines could give the different forecasting because it uses the random distribution with the certain parameters. But this approach was very useful and beneficial in our cases, as we have the highly stochastic and with high level of noise time series, which are difficult to predict. So that's all for the method. Very briefly, the summary for the time series forecasting. I want to highlight that the situation in the time series and methods for the time series are changing all over the time. So all of these presented methods are quite new or just matured in the last one or two years, so it is very important to be in touch with the latest development in that area. And also the new method, especially the one presented by me in the presentation, has a significantly better better results than statistical methods or even the previous one. So if you are thinking seriously about the forecasting, especially difficult time series, then I strongly suggest to take a look on that methods because the result could be significantly better than using the statistical method or a simple machine learning method like LSTM neural networks or so. For the financial time series, we get the accuracy over 60% in the long term, which is usually not good because on the different time series, the accuracy is much higher, but this time series, financial time series are very difficult to predict due to the heteroscedasticity, high level of noise and stochastic nature. So the 60% in the long term gives us a very significant edge, and this edge could be used, of course, is in also many other areas. And I also want to show the real results, so what we are achieving using that that approaches, and it is especially very interesting that we have a very difficult time for the investing. Last year and the financial crisis caused by the COVID-19 creates non-standard situation for the investing, but we have a very interesting results after that period. The first one is probably the most obvious. So this methods improves the investments results, but also stabilize the rate of the return and minimize the variance of the return. Also, it minimizes the risk, and which is very important, it allows for the low correlation with the base market. So the results generated by our methods and our platform is in the very low correlation with the base market like S&P 500 or stock market and other markets. So here we can see our results, you know, for the different class of the actives. These red one lines are ours, and here we have the comparison to the other hedge fund S&P 500 and also VIX. And the most important thing which we can see is this smooth of this curve. Yeah, of course there are some losses somewhere, but the curve is generally very smooth, which will improve the minimize the risk and improve the confidence to our method. So that's the very important. This low correlation, yeah, we can present here the correlation to the other hedge funds and to the S&P market, and you can see that as the other hedge funds are rather correlated with the base market, our results are not exactly correlated. So this level of the correlation is the quite small, and it proves that this method works, and really provide this edge to the investing. And of course, as I said, we are continuously working on the both time series forecasting and also the optimization and other machine learning methods for the investments. So it is not it not works that way that we have some methods and we can stop today and be happy forever, because as you can imagine, in the investments world, there is a ongoing race who can provide better returns. So we are continuously analyzing the latest achievements in that area, both for the time series and other machine learning methods, and try to apply that. So let's hope that in the next year I could provide a presentation with the more updated methods, more results, and some other suggestions in that area. Thank you very much.